Hi, welcome once again to Learning English Language Classes. In the previous video, we learned how a sentence is constructed. It is a group of words that makes a complete sentence. Now, in this session, we would see how a sentence is divided. It's divided into two parts, subject and predicate. Let's learn about these two parts. In the previous video, we learned about the group of words that make a complete sentence. To stay in continuation, try these and then we will move on to subject and predicate. When we write or speak a sentence, we must have a subject to speak about, the doer, and something about his actions or intentions. In other words, something about the subject. This is called the predicate of the sentence. For example, barking dogs seldom bite. Who is the doer here? Barking dogs. What do they do? Seldom bite. So the subject is barking dogs and the predicate is seldom bite. Usually, the doer or the subject comes first in the sentence, but occasionally it is put after the predicate. For example, there goes the train. Here, the train is a subject. In the bottom of the sea lies the treasure. The treasure is the subject. So the things can change according to the sentence structure. At times when there is an order or an advice, the subject is understood. Like if we say work hard, so we are saying to you. So the subject is you, but it's understood. Take this medicine thrice a day. In this, you is a subject, but it's not said, so subject is understood. Here's a small exercise for you. These are 10 sentences. What you have to do is you have to separate the subject and the predicate. What I would suggest is you pause the video, do the exercise, and then match your answers. That would be on the next slide. Hope you were able to get most of the answers right. If not, then try them once again, and if you still have some questions, put them in the comments and we would be more than happy to answer them.